Just pedaling raw, coming at you live from my bedroom. And all wrapped up, all nice and warm and cosy. Went for a ride earlier, went for a ride Saturday as well. Saturday was an epic day. It was really, really blue sky. And I headed out about 7 a.m. Sun was just coming up. And there's quite a bit of traffic around, but not too bad on the main road. And the sun was just coming up over to my left. And it was really nice. It's nice. I mean, could have been a summer's morning, you know, but it's not. It's cold. It's winter. It's middle of winter. So the whole ride, I just kept moving, really. Went over to the hills, did a few little climbs. Not really, you know, nothing hard, just easy, really. Just chilling out on the bike, just a simple spin. Drunk some OJ. Didn't listen to any music. I always take my earphones with me, though, just in case I want to listen to some music or some podcasts or something. But it's quite blowing cold once I was on top of the hills. There's been a lot of rain lately and storms and stuff. So this hill that I went up, this particular hill, was like flooded with like stones. There were like rocks and everything as well, like come right off the hill. So I had like a tiny little bit of single track I was going along, which was cool. But it was a hill I hadn't gone up before, and there was this massive drop at the top. Obviously, it was all like fenced off and stuff. But yeah, I won a bad ride, actually. And today I kind of like went out again. It was all right. I went out anyway. It started to piss down after about 4 hours of blue sky and sun, and I decided to go out when it's raining. But I wrapped up, long as my core was pretty warm. It was pretty good. I mean, I did about 48 miles, just like a loop, and I just kept moving. I just prayed for not getting a puncture or something, because when you're that wet and it's that cold, it's not the best, is it? Really, really difficult to get warm again. Just an out and back, literally. I mean, when I say an out and back ride, for me, yeah, can be anything between 50 and 100 miles. That's how I gauge it in my experience anyway. I mean, out and backs, loops, endurance rides, epics. In my head, I've got my own sort of gauges and estimates on that. It's a bit like surfers, isn't it? You know, surfers say, oh, it's about a five foot swell today, or a 10 foot swell or whatever. I mean, people have got their own, I mean, physically like 6 foot bang on, like, or 2 meters or whatever, in some person's eyes might be more like 4 meters or 10 foot or something. You know, everyone's got their own descriptions. So yeah, it was just like a little loop of about 48 miles, which was cool. What I was going to say about just getting involved with this whole vegan thing, man. I like to be involved with it. That's why I'm on YouTube doing my bits and pieces. But as far as, like I said in a previous video about Facebook and stuff, it can take up so much of your time. So come on here and say something if you've got something to say. It can just get, it's just so around in circles. Like, even a lot of these people they're all right people, like, you know. But it's just, I just want to be doing my thing and not making a big deal of it. Just getting up every day and not making a big deal of it, really. If people want help, then I'm here to help you. If you want to ask me for advice or anything, whether you know me personally, or you've just discovered my channel, or you're a new subscriber, feel free to message me on here or email me, peddlingraw@gmail.com or something. I'll do the best I can, man. Started this lifestyle, I guess, sort of April 2011, just creeping towards to where I am now. And I'm not hard on myself. Like, I just finished a ride now, and I'm cold. I'm warmer now, but I was cold when I came in. So I had like a big mug of, check out my mug, man. My Disney Piglet mug of herbal tea. And I just had a couple of these things with it. Just little like cereal crunch bar things. Because I didn't want to drink some cold orange juice or fucking banana smoothie. Excuse the expletives. But yeah, sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. So I just don't want to be like, think that's what I got to have all the time. I mean, some people do, and perhaps they don't I don't care actually. Like, you know, I even had like a milk chocolate biscuit the other day. A milk chocolate biscuit. I'm just being honest. There was a Christmas selection thing on the worktop, and I had a cup of tea, and I had a milk chocolate biscuit. Now, if that makes me a bad person, I don't give a shit. But there's lots of things people do out there. There's lots of things people have done in the past, because I'm only new to this. The majority of my intake is fresh fruits and veggies and stuff, and rice and quinoa, starches, pasta, blah, 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 all that sort of stuff. But I'm not going to colour wash it that I'm 100% raw. Hence my name, Peddling Raw. It's not necessarily about eating 100% raw, Peddling Raw. It's just the vision, you know. It's just the, I mean, most of the rides I've done have been on raw foods or like orange juice, you know, cooked juice or something. I have done like a banana island for a couple of days and drunk just sort of OJ for one day and things. I mean, I've done my little things, you know, my little experiments. I mean, I'm going to just keep on experimenting, and I say to you to do the same, really. Don't listen to one person. Everyone's got different activity levels. Some people are more physically active than others, some are not. You just got to just play around with that. And all because someone's, say like myself, goes out and does 100 plus mile cycle rides, and they're drinking like banana smoothies and doing all what I do, it don't mean you've got to do the same. If you're cycling or doing some less activity than that, then you perhaps don't want to be as having as much calories, I guess. You've got to play around with it. Or you don't, I mean, sometimes I don't want to slam back a huge smoothie. It just kind of like sits there in my gut, you know. I'd sooner have like half a Vitamix jug and drink the rest later. I'll put it in a jar or something. So yeah, just want to say that. But yeah, I mean, there's people out there that who are not even active out on Facebook or YouTube or anything. They just do their thing. That's what, just what I want to be doing my thing and setting an example, really. I can picture some, I'm going to call them vegan nut jobs, because I think they are vegan nut jobs. The people that, as soon as they wake up, they're in vegan mode, if you know what I mean. Yeah, I live in Vegansville, but I don't want to really make a big thing of it. I don't really give a fuck like that, if you know what I mean. I am what I am. I'm just an ordinary person trying something different. That's all I am, an ordinary person. I'm not a superstar. I'm not famous. Don't want to be famous. I'm just me. Justin. You can call me Justin. That's my name. Or Just. Actually, I prefer to be called Jay. Some people call me Jay. Some people don't. Just. Jay. Justin. Whatever. No big deal. There's my name. That's all you're getting. Because, yeah, it makes it a bit more personal. And the people that know me, they know what my name is anyway. That watch me on here. Because I've got subscribers on here who I don't actually know what their YouTube names are, but they might be people that I know, so what up. And the people that don't, then there you go. So you can follow me on Strava, and I'm on Facebook as Peddling Raw, so go and check that out. I forgot what I was gonna say, man. Damn, I need to carve the fuck up. But yeah, just do your own thing, and don't let what other people are doing bring you down, because you might not look as skinny as them, or you're fatter than what they were when they first started out, or something like that. Just play around with it. I watched a video just a minute ago with Victoria Arnstein, and she was going on about the protein, more protein and more carbs and things. I mean, if that's what you want to try, go and try that. You might fuck up, and then you come and try the high carb thing, whatever. Or because someone says, oh no, you don't want to try this, you don't want to. Sometimes you just have to find out for yourself. Find out for yourself. Judge by results, not by theory, isn't it? Where have we heard that before? So judge by results, not by theory. And see what works for you, really. Man, today was pretty interesting going down the main road. All these trucks going past me and that. I had a blazing rear light on the go. And a little blinky flashing with fresh batteries, which was pretty good. But yeah, learn to drive a car properly before you get on the road. Like, there should be some sort of test where, well, firstly, people want to ride motorbikes, don't they? Or ride bicycles. And then get like a certificate or test for that, then step into a car. And before people do actually get up in the morning, they want to have their pint of water, get hydrated. It don't just apply to an active lifestyle. Getting in the car, you need to be carved up. You need to be like clipped on. Simple as that. You know, getting in a car involves being alert, because you end up fucking killing somebody, couldn't you? So get some fuel in your body. Because people, what are they actually worried about day to day now? They're worried about if their iPhone's fueled up, i.e. charged. If there's decent fuel in the car, i.e. petrol tank's full up. But themselves, they're just scoffing down all this shit all the time, aren't they? How can you be like switched on and active and clued up behind the wheel of a motor vehicle if you're drinking crap food? Well, yeah, eating and drinking crap food all the time. It's a no-brainer, isn't it? And people are smoking at the wheel. You know, they're on their mobile phones. They're eating stuff. And see, that's what I'm getting at. It's not a game out there, is it? I mean, yeah, life is a roller coaster up and down and stuff. But you just got to be careful, man. You've got to be so careful. Because a lot of these cyclists on the road, they're policemen, they're ambulancemen. They're office workers. They work in factories. Some have got one kid, some got two kids, some haven't got any kids. Some are married, some aren't. You know, you got people from all walks of life. These people don't get up every morning and just go and ride their bike on the road. They're living people just like yourself. You know, they might do the same job as you. They might drive a skip lorry, they might work for Royal Mail. Whatever, man. So people should just all share the road together. But it's just some of the stuff you see, isn't it? You get a corner coming up on the road, and that means the car should come past you, shouldn't it, overtake you? No, it fucking doesn't. You wait behind, and so you can see around the corner, especially on blind bends, and if it's clear, come by. Or if you wasted 5 seconds, you can take all of a second just to kill someone, can't it? And those islands in the middle of the road, I mean, usually they're about 4.5 metres wide. I couldn't give a shit how wide they are, to be honest. Because I'll just take the whole road up on those things. Keep the traffic back. Sometimes my hand goes out, well, my old arm. Hold traffic back. And then when it's safe to do so, I'll move in. They can come on by. Another one's like blind crests on bridges. Again, move right out on the road, man. Take up width of the car and hold the car back. Because they can come by, and if there's someone coming the other way doing exactly the same thing, there's going to be a nasty collision. I've seen some seriously crazy things on that sort of setup, with cars like braking on bridges and skidding and all sorts of stuff. It's the first car that comes up on a cyclist on the road. It's their job to let all the other cars behind know that there's a cyclist there, i.e. giving that cyclist a wide berth. But not only just giving them a wide berth, signalling as well. I could go on and on and on, stuff like this. So I don't really get me down much, it's just chitter chatter. So bit of a random bit again. I didn't really know what I was gonna say, but if you get something from that, cool, man. 2014, we're kicking in here, middle of January's coming on. It's all cool. It's all cool. I'm still in school. Keep learning, don't stop learning, don't listen to just one person. Read some books, try and get some knowledge in your nut, fill that memory box up best you can, get to know a bit of law as well, that's a good thing to learn, try and get into some of that. Anyway, yeah, whatever, see you next video, take care, and just do the best you can, people.